Hey, what's going on, everyone? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I am incredibly excited to show you guys how to make these super creative infinite zoom transitions and then sauce them up with the free Saber plugin in After Effects. These types of transitions are a little bit more advanced and take longer to make, but hey, that's the name of the game. I appreciate everyone who supports the channel. We got some new editing packs on the way in 2023. Step one in Premiere Pro is going to be identifying the point at where we want this transition to start happening. I highly recommend looking for an opportunity within your clips where you can start transitioning with something in the middle of the frame. So this shot works perfect because we're going to zoom through the middle part of this steering wheel here. The clip that we're transitioning to looks like this. Let's highlight both these clips, right click, and hit replace with After Effects composition. Step one in After Effects is coming to the end of our first clip here where this transition is going to begin. We're going to come up under our grid options and we're going to select proportional grid. You can see that the grid helps us determine where the exact middle point of our frame is. So what we want to do is just increase the size of our clip a little bit, and then we're going to move our clip over until it's exactly centered in the frame where we're going to be transitioning. From here, I'm just going to turn our proportional grid back off. With our top clip selected, I'm going to hit Command Shift D to cut this last frame. Now you're gonna wanna right click on this frame right here, come up to time and hit freeze frame, and then we can extend this out over the clip that we're transitioning to. So as I play it back here, you can see it comes to a stop, boom, right there. And the point we're transitioning through is directly in the middle of our frame. Select our freeze frame. We're going to zoom in on this point just so we can see it a little bit better. Come up to the pen tool and start masking around this point in our shot. So you can see as I complete the mask there, the rest of the shot fades away and we're left with our next clip showing through. We want to come down to our masks and we want to invert our mask on that layer. To see this a little bit better, I'm just going to go ahead and hide our next clip. So you can see now we have the transparency grid showing behind the steering wheel mask. Now what I'm going to do with our freeze frame layer is duplicate it by hitting Command D. I'm going to open our mask on the new layer we just created and deselect the invert so our cap layer remains. So we're just going to rename this layer to cap. Now if I turn that layer off and on, you can see we have it showing. The next step for me is going to be selecting the cap layer, coming up here to layer and selecting Autotrace. We'll keep the Autotrace settings on current frame and make sure you have apply to new layer selected and then hit okay. That's going to create an Autotrace layer of our cap. What we're going to do is now apply the Saber plugin, which is a free plugin for After Effects. You get these really cool kind of glowing lines that you can put around different objects. We've just placed the Saber plugin onto our Autotrace layer. I'm going to change the Saber preset to electric. It's one of my favorites. Turn down a few settings here so the glow isn't as intense. Drop down customize core and change the core type from Saber to layer masks. The last step for this is coming down to render settings and changing the composite settings from black to transparent. And now we should be seeing something like this where our Saber outline is now around our middle point here that we're going to be zooming through. Just move our Autotrace cap layer beneath our original cap layer right there. Now with my Autotrace cap layer selected with Saber on it, I'm going to drop down the effects, open up Saber, open up customize core, and I'm going to keyframe the end offset. I'm going to move this keyframe to the right a little bit, and then I'm going to make a keyframe here at the beginning with the end offset at 0. Now as I scroll over these frames, you can see our Saber line starts to kind of trace around where we're going to be zooming through. So pretty cool little effect to kind of introduce the Saber line into this clip. And I am noticing that this cap layer looks a little bit too rigid around these edges. So what I'm gonna do is just open up my cap layer here and we're going to feather the mask a little bit more. So boom, just kind of helps blend it with that Saber line. At this point, what I'm gonna do is turn off the cap layer and the background layer. So all we have is this kind of freeze frame right here with the Saber line. I'm going to adjust my timeline in and out points here so that we can render this little section of our timeline. I'm gonna come up under composition, hit add to render queue. Here in the render queue, you wanna make sure that your output module is set to lossless with alpha so that we can render this with transparency. We'll just save this to our desktop and call it zoom and then hit render. back in our After Effects timeline, I'm just going to delete our Autotrace layer now, and I'm also going to delete our transparent steering wheel layer. So we should just be left with basically nothing at this point. Here in Finder, I can see that zoom clip that we just rendered out of After Effects. I'm just gonna click and drag it onto our timeline here and move it over to where this transition is going to be happening. I'm gonna move it below our cap layer. So now this is what we have so far. So boom, the original clip, and then it freezes, it gets transparent, and boom, we have our Saber line. Now with this zoom clip that we've rendered out, I'm going to change it to 3D here, and then I'm going to duplicate it several times. So we're going to hit Command D, maybe once, twice, three times, four times, five times. Just depends how many loops you kind of want to zoom through. Now what I'm going to do just to stay organized is rename our top zoom here just to top zoom. So what I'm going to do now is highlight all these other layers we just duplicated and hit P to open up the position options. Now since we turned on the 3D option for these layers, we can now move them around in 3D space. So with this layer, this second zoom layer here, we're going to change it from a 0. We're going to change this to something like 700. The next one will be 1400. The next one will be 2100, and so on by intervals of 700. So that's what I'm just doing here. It's all just even math here. We're just multiplying by 7 a bunch of times. So now you can see we have a tunnel of kind of different layers starting to appear here. So underneath all of our layers, I'm gonna right click, hit new camera. The default settings should be just fine. So I'm just gonna hit okay. And then I'm going to right click again and hit null object. With our null object selected, I'm going to hit command on my keyboard. I'm going to double click the pan behind tool here at the top. That's just going to center up our center point here for our null object. And then we're going to move it to the very center of our zoom through transition. We're going to turn the 3D option on for this null object, and then we're going to parent the camera to this null object. Now with our null object selected, I'm just going to hit P to pull up our position keyframes here, and at the beginning of our transition, I'm going to make a keyframe, and then towards the end of our transition where we want it to stop, this is where we're going to zoom in the position. So you can see as I start to change this value, we're starting to zoom through all of these different layers here that we've created, all the different Saber lines, and it looks really, really cool. Wait till you guys see this in full motion. So we just want to zoom through here all the way until we don't see any more of that Saber line. I'm going to right click on the second keyframe and hit easy ease in, right click on our first keyframe and hit easy ease out. You can see we're starting to get the transition happening. So what I'm gonna do at this point is just turn on motion blur for all of my layers. It's just gonna help blend that transition. When we zoom through all these layers a little bit better, it's gonna make them a little bit more blurry. Now if I turn motion blur off, you can see the difference there. And this is where the cap mask comes into play. So remember that cap layer we made in the very beginning? Well, we're gonna turn it back on now so that it's over our steering wheel here. We're gonna also turn on the 3D option for that layer as well. Now you can see this is where the transition is going to start happening. So we're gonna select our cap layer. We're gonna click P on our keyboard to open up the position, and we're gonna make a keyframe there at the very beginning. And now as the zoom starts to move, we're going to just have this layer drop out of the way, and it's going to kind of reveal the rest of the transition. So I'm actually going to move this keyframe down here a little bit so it doesn't drop too fast. And I'm going to right click on this first keyframe and hit easy ease out so it kind of falls away a little bit more gradually. At this point, what I'm going to do is turn our next clip back on here at the bottom so it starts to show through when we pull through the rest of this transition. So now as I, you know, kind of scroll through this transition here, we're starting to see the next clip kind of come into play. Now, what I recommend doing is taking your clip that you're transitioning to here on the bottom and turning its 3D option on. We're going to look at this last zoom layer and see how far back it is. So 3,500. So now we're going to open up the transform options for our next clip. We're going to change the position. Let's go to like 4,200 right here. And now you should see it come into frame here. And with the 3D turned on, it's just gonna zoom in kind of with the camera movement. Now you can see this is way too big here. So let's just zoom it out a little bit. Let's just find that sweet spot for that next clip here. You can see the edges start to come in right there. So boom, almost got it right about there. We can see pretty much the whole clip. So now as we're zooming through this tunnel, this next clip is actually going to kind of be zooming in as well. To kind of eliminate this transparency here at the top and the bottom of your clip as we're zooming through, is just throw on some motion tile. We're gonna throw on some motion tile onto this clip, and we're going to change the output height. So we're just gonna increase the output height there, and you'll see that that fills in kind of this bottom area. And then what I like to do to kind of blend it in to its maximum potential is just select mirror edges, and now you can see we got a really nice blend here on the bottom. The viewers are probably not going to notice this, and it's just gonna kind of help overall smooth out the entire transition. What I'm gonna do to kind of smooth it out even more is just open up my null object keyframes by hitting U, and then I'm going to get in my keyframe graph editor and just tweak these graphs a little bit so that it kind of gradually comes into the shot a little bit better that way. So here it is all together now. We got boom, perfect transition. You can see how kind of changing those keyframe easy ease ins with the graph editor changed and enhanced the overall transition, and now it just looks super dope. These types of transitions in After Effects are a little bit more advanced and do require a lot more attention to the finer details. That still should not deter any of you from trying to make your own zoom through transitions. I know a lot of this can seem intimidating, especially to beginners, but what's really important is that you maintain your patience and continue to strive to make better visuals. I hope today's tutorial helps some of you guys out there understand a little bit more about how 3D space works and how you can use the camera and null object in After Effects. As always, I do want to mention that if you're a video editor looking to add some sauce to your next edit today, definitely consider checking out my free pack on venturvisuals.com. We got overlays, transitions, title templates, and more, which you can use and test out for free on your own visual projects. So if that sounds interesting to you, make sure to check the links out down below. And please comment below any tutorials you might want to see me create for the future. I'm always interested to hear what this community has to say. I really appreciate everyone taking the time to watch this tutorial today. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.